In recent years, one crime sent all of Japan on a downward spiral of fear. A gruesome tragedy that rattled consciences. In part, because of the brazen brutality. But more so, for where it happened. One elementary school became the scene for a murder among classmates. Japan has often been described as one of the safest countries in the world, buoyed up for centuries by a disciplined and courteous population. But in recent years, fissures have emerged within this conservative country, with spurts of rebellion and deviance. Incidents of youth rage have sent shockwaves, threatening the foundations of an otherwise polite, civic-minded society. Famed for its scenic beauty, this port city in Nagasaki Prefecture is a quaint and quiet seaside town that was not spared the horror of World War II bombings. In recent years, though, Sasebo has gained a new notoriety, due largely to an event that struck horror in the hearts of all Japan, the Sasebo slashing. In accordance with Japanese juvenile laws, some of the characters in this case cannot be named. The year is 2004. Girl A, as she's now described by Japanese media, is 11. Born to a middle-class family. She seemed to many around her in this small town like any regular Japanese schoolgirl. She had her usual cohort of friends, an array of childhood hobbies, and didn't stand out from the crowd. Beneath the surface, though, there were troubles at home.
俺の人生どうしてこんな?
Her family life was mired by a host of negative issues. She had an abusive father, and what many of her neighbors would term an incompetent mother. It would be these domestic troubles that would contribute significantly to a void in her life. Girl A bottled up the trauma she was experiencing at home, keeping sane through her distractions. She began to develop a keen interest in art and immersed herself in it, apart from having other aspirations to be a writer. Aside from her hobbies, Girl A was a conscientious student. Japan's education system is notorious for being competitive to the extreme. In a context such as this, it is often lamented that a child's future is decided by his university entrance examination. Getting into the right university will set him up for life. And so, the pressure begins early. Children spend the better part of their lives preparing for the big exam, which they will only attempt when they reach 16. Girl A did her level best to cope with the demands of the system, but eventually sought to escape the pressures in a manner not uncommon among her peers. She found solace on the internet. There she maintained a personal blog site where she poured out most of her feelings and emotions.
一つは日本の今の社会では地域のつながりが非常に薄くて、子どもたちが周囲から自分を認められているという感覚を持ちにくい状況があります。
Daisuke Fujikawa is a professor at Chiba University. His research specialization is on the proliferation of internet usage among Japanese youth and the resulting dangers of this addiction to the virtual world.
内側の人たちには自分のことを何でも知ってほしい。包み隠さず自分の思いを知ってほしいというふうになりやすい。 ですから友達に見せたくてブログに何でも書いてしまうということがあると考えられます。子どもたちに聞くと毎日会っている友達との間でも面と向かっては言いにくいことがあるっていうふうに言うんですね。
スポーツ was another of Girl A's personal passions. She was a keen basketball player and even made it into the ranks of her school team. Basketball, like her other passions, helped ease off some of the rough edges in her life. It even kept her mind away from a troubled home environment. But when her grades started to fall,Girl A was forced to quit. An ominous beginning to a tragedy that was beginning to unfold.
大丈夫よ。試験の試験はもっと頑張って。
うるさい、お前。お前、今からバスケットボールやめろ。
Girl A was a quiet girl with few friends. Struggling with falling grades, she was forced to give up her favorite pastime, basketball. Having withdrawn from the game, she quickly lost the valuable bond that she had established with her teammates. With one comforting pastime denied her, she felt alone and alienated.The problem was exacerbated by the fact that she lived way up in the mountains at a remote part of the town, inaccessible to many of her classmates. Unlike most primary school girls in Japan, who would often have friends visit, Girl A was left detached from her school community. She even felt a stranger at her own home.
お前話してるよ。おい、座って。おい、お前どこ行くの？
Feeling numb and disconnected, Girl A was drawn deeper to life in the virtual world.which had now become her refuge. Japanese youth are the epitome of tech savviness, with Japan being one of the most prolific users of consumer technology. For many, daily interaction takes place via indirect communication, by short message systems, blog sites, emails and the like. Japanese youth get exposed to online chat rooms at a very young age,which in the view of some experts, has caused devastating consequences on the nature of human relationships. By 11, Girl A was already spending most of her waking hours in chat rooms.
それはインターネットの能力の問題というよりも、家庭生活とか、コミュニケーション能力、あるいはネゴシエーション能力、そういったところに課題がある子どもたちがインターネットもうまく使いこなせずに自信がないためについつい依存傾向を持ってたくさんメールを出してしまうとか。
At school, Girl A had a few tenuous friendships. A classmate by the name of Satomi Mitarai was one of her acquaintances, whom she befriended through the school's computer club. Once they became proficient enough on the computer, they made most of their contact online.It was round about then that she began to soak in a barrage of extraordinary influences from the internet and popular culture. She was especially drawn to a particular type of content that for young audiences seemed extreme. Graphic images of death and gore had a particular resonance for her. It seemed to empower her with thoughts of vengeance. Due to her father's poor health,Medical expenses left the family with barely sufficient means to tide over their daily needs. Girl A hence became an easy target of bullying among her materialistic classmates, plunging her further into depths of alienation.
彼女の家はそれほど裕福ではなく、それもお父様の病気のせいで裕福ではなかったので、他の洋服とかカバンとかいろんなものにお金を使いたがって見せびらかす女の子たちにとっては 彼女はいじめの標的でした。流行りのものを持っていない、それだけでいじめの標的になったのです。
Bullying is a long-standing social problem in Japan. It occurs often in the form of exclusion and of banding to ostracize, where individuals are targeted and isolated from the pack. Soon, girl A would adopt her own countermeasures to deal with the hollowness of alienation. She would transform from being the victim to being the bully, and a very extreme one at that. One particular boy, Naoki, not his real name, would bear the brunt of that rage. They were friends at first, sharing a common love for books and manga, the Japanese passion for comics.
ですから彼女は最初から人をいじめるような暴力を振るうような子ではありませんでしたが、同じクラスの同じ人間関係の中で大きくなり、また家庭の事情もあってどんどんストレスが溜まっていきました。4年生5年生になった時に彼女のストレスが溜まって、それがインターネットの世界に浸ってしまったり、またクラスの心の優しい反撃しない子どもたちへの暴力になって現れてきました。
Naoki's mother had known girl A for 6 years and acknowledges the friendship the girl had with her boy. Before her very eyes, she witnessed a drastic change in girl A's behavior, the build-up before the catastrophe set to change the lives of everyone in this small school in Sasebo. With time, girl A's rage grew more violent and intense, snapping into sudden fits of rage, known in Japan as Kireru. Now isolated from much human contact, girl A seemed to be sucked deeper into her obsessions. She was drawn into even darker content. Her favorite obsession being Battle Royale. This is based on a popular novel, film, and later manga spin-off, which contained graphic scenes of classmates killing one another in a deadly game of survival. One expert believes that obsessive engagement with such content has dire consequences.
で、まあ、日本でいうと切れやすい、非常にその、理性が外れた動物的になってしまうと。したがって思考、ものを考えるということは前頭前野関与しなくなると。したがってそこに信号がネットワークとして信号がいかないために脳全体がこう低下してくる。でその結果、その善悪の判断とか、それから将来の計画とか、そういうものが全て失われてくるということが起こってきます。
According to Dr. Morris's theory, known as game brain, people with excessive exposure to certain actions or to certain themes develop a loss in the side of the brain that encourages logic and reasoning.The theory is still not regarded as an exact science, but Mori argues that girl A's violent tendencies have much to do with her obsessions.
まあ、あの、まあ、実態はよくわかりませんけども、まあ、チャットとかパソコンを結構使ってたということを考えますと、やはりあの、まあ、それは短い時間であればいいんですけども、毎日長時間使ってると、やはり前頭前野の働きが悪くなる。まあ、映像とかそういうのはあまり見てしまうと、やはりその、まあ、自分も実際なんかそういうその行動、まあ、そういったものとこうオーバーラップしてしまう部分って結構あると思うんですよね。
Her sudden fits of rage terrified her classmates. And for one boy,It would be the first of several actions that would come to scar him emotionally. After girl A came to be alienated from friends and school, she became increasingly withdrawn. Finally, one day, what started as a cordial friendship became an overture to an unfolding tragedy. The boy later suffered from post-traumatic depression syndrome, spurred on, as his mother believes, not by the actions of the girl, but by the insensitivity of his teachers. As for girl A, her violent streak and instances of rampage were starting to gain momentum.
でおんぶをこうして遊んだりするんですけれども、そのおんぶをしてもして、御手洗さんとかその他の人とかという彼女と課外女子とかしていたんだけれども。
Atsuko Kusanagi is a freelance journalist and author. She spent close to a year researching the Sasebo slashing and speaking to major protagonists whose lives revolved around the case.
彼女は普通の体格で、別にその太ってるわけでもないんだけれども、冗談で重い重いっていうふうに、御手洗さんが言っちゃったっていうことがあるんですね。それを彼女は、重いっていうのは自分が太ってるからだという、そのまあ思春期の女の子はそういうダイエットとかね、そういうことも気にして体の体型とかも気にするんですけれども、で重い重いって言われたと、それが冗談じゃなくて私を攻撃しているっていうふうに、彼女はと加害女児は取ってしまったっていうのがあるんです。
It has been suggested that another possible reason for girl A's behavior can be tied to Asperger's syndrome, a condition she was believed to be suffering fromIt's common for sufferers of Asperger's to be unable to distinguish between fantasy and reality, thereby leading them to misinterpret situations. The more aggressive girl A became, the more isolated she became from her classmates. Eventually, she was even abandoned by her best friend, Satomi. Girl A was left livid and feeling utterly betrayed.This set the course for a tragedy that erupted on school grounds one sunny summer afternoon.
Satomi-chan! Chotto surprise-o aritai.
彼女のやってることはやっぱり模倣なので、もしそういうのを見なかったらこういう事件につながらなかったと思います。例えばそのバトルロワイヤルで、ある女優の子がですね、女の子をこうカッターナイフで殺すっていうことがあったんです。カッターナイフじゃない、それは斧かなんかもっと違うもので殺すっていうのがあったんですけれども、その時にこう血が吹き飛ぶというのがあったんです。彼女はそれを見て、あ、すごい綺麗だと思ったと。
Girl A could not comprehend the magnitude of what she'd done and was later quoted in Japanese media as being remorseful. She had planned every aspect of the murder for 4 days. It played out in her tormented mind. Just like playing a computer game, she chose to log off her friendship with Satomi.And killing her was the only way she knew how. Girl A was sentenced to involuntary confinement and is still undergoing rehabilitation today. On the other side of the equation, Satomi's father remains inconsolable. The family had already lost Satomi's mother to cancer years before. In a desperate attempt to escape the painful memory, he moved out of Sasebo, living now in reclusion. He hopes, though,that his daughter's death will serve as a lesson in tolerance and restraint for all youth, that they will consider how their actions will affect the people who love them. The 13-year economic slump in Japan has sent divorce, domestic violence and suicide rates soaring, and has alienated parents from their children, crumbling the very foundation of Japanese culture, the family. In Japan, many instances of juvenile crime stem from stress and developmental problems due to a lack of attention, rather than poverty, as may be the case elsewhere. While overall crime rates among minors have decreased since the 1980s, a handful of very extreme manifestations of youth rage in recent years have rattled the public conscience. Growing concerns by some sectors of society have prompted harsher penalties by the courts. And in a bid to address the causes as well as the symptoms of juvenile crime, the government has also introduced campaigns to encourage parents to reconnect with their children. A reality that unfortunately came a little too late for a lost soul like Girl A.